This presentation regards the construction and use of a manometer for chemistry 1412 laboratory at Lamar University. These directions are meant to be applicable to both online and on-campus sections of the laboratory. The materials you'll need include a yardstick, a meter stick, or even just a 3-foot stick. The other materials are about 10 feet of 1/4-inch outer diameter by 0.17-inch inner diameter polyethylene tubing like that used for ice maker water connections, a 10-milliliter oral syringe, clear cellophane tape, mineral or vegetable oil, several sheets of unlined paper, a pen or pencil, and a ruler with millimeter markings. The construction of the manometer is very simple. Place one end of the tubing just slightly above the top of the stick and run it along the side of the stick, securing it in several places with clear tape. Near the very bottom of the stick, loop the tubing, taking care not to crimp it. Run the tubing back up the stick, again using the clear tape to secure it along the side of the stick. Use the syringe to add about 13 milliliters of oil to the tubing. This will fill it about halfway up the stick on both sides. Once the oil is in the tubing, use a syringe to move the oil up and down to remove any air bubbles. Once the oil is bubble free and without the syringe attached, the oil should settle at the same level on both sides of the tubing. 3 sheets of paper can be taped together and taped to the top and bottom of the stick. The paper can be marked with the oil level to determine the change in pressure that occurs when the syringe is attached and the plunger is depressed. After each depression of the plunger to a new volume, allow a few seconds for the system to respond and settle to a new level. If the level does not stabilize, there's probably an air leak where the syringe is attached to the tubing. For each volume change, each change in plunger position, the oil level should be marked on the paper as here and here. The data to be collected and recorded includes the atmospheric pressure, P atmosphere, at the time and location of the experiment. This data can be easily obtained from WeatherBug or AccuWeather in units of inches of mercury. This value needs to be converted to units of millimeters of oil using the method given in the laboratory directions. For each depression of the syringe plunger in increments of 1 milliliter, the corresponding change in the height of oil should be determined by measuring the distance between the corresponding pair of marks on the paper. The total pressure related to each volume increment is the total of the atmospheric pressure reading and the oil height change reading for each volume. Reading the syringe is actually easy. Note there are 2 dark bands at the end of the plunger. The volume to which the plunger is withdrawn is determined by reading the value at which the dark band closest to where the syringe tip is located. In this image, the syringe is at 2.00 milliliter along this line.